Welcome to the first episode of Rapid Fire Video Game News. Rapid Fire Video Game News is the quickest way to hear about all the biggest video game news each week. Remember to like and subscribe if you enjoy. ESA, the company behind E3, released a statement regarding the coronavirus. In summary, the show goes on, but they will be monitoring the situation closely to ensure it's safe for attendees in June. However, with the way COVID-19 continues to spread, I wouldn't be surprised if this year's show is cancelled, or at least postponed like GDC was. Let's hope this isn't the final nail in the coffin for E3. Valve has showed off Half-Life Alyx again, as we approach the release date later this month. We learned of the three different ways you're able to move in VR, by teleporting, walking normally, or shifting around the level. Additionally, we saw some interesting mechanics, such as using gravity gloves to grab items from the environment, throw back grenades, or even opening a car door as cover. This game really might be what convinces the masses to give VR a shot. Riot Games, the developers behind League of Legends, have finally revealed their new game, a multiplayer tactical FPS called Valorant. In the gameplay preview, they showed off what can only be described as Counter-Strike meets Overwatch. Riot Games have dominated the MOBA market. Now, can they become the master of the tactical shooter as well?
Okay. I got B. I can help you get out.
I'm out.
Sony's brand new IP, Ghost of Tsushima, finally has a confirmed release date of June 26th. They also showed off a story trailer to give you a feel of what's to come. This year is turning out to be one hell of a year for gamers.
When we fight, we face our enemy head on. And when we take their life, we look them in the eye with courage and respect.
It's official, Death Stranding is coming to PC on June 2nd, and with some added features too. This includes a higher frame rate, a brand new photo mode, and ultra-wide support. It'll be coming to Steam and the Epic Game Store. I can't wait to see how pretty this game will look on PC. The Final Fantasy VII Remake demo that was previously leaked shadow dropped on the PlayStation Store this week, so you should absolutely check that out ASAP. It is hands down one of the greatest demos I've ever played.
Brace yourself.
You guys remember that mobile Mario Kart game? Well, multiplayer for it has dropped. It features both a ranked mode, where you can compete against players across the globe, and a custom mode, where you can go head-to-head against your friends. A new Star Wars game called Project Maverick has accidentally been leaked to the European PlayStation Store. There's not much to note besides the art, so all we can do at this point is speculate. A TV show adaptation of The Last of Us is currently in the works. Craig Mazin, creator-director of HBO's Chernobyl, will be the mastermind behind the show. He'll be working alongside Neil Druckmann to tell the story of The Last of Us. They said it may even expand further beyond the first game, into the sequel, which occurs 5 years later. Earlier this week, Halo Combat Evolved Shadow dropped on PC through the Master Chief Collection. MCC on PC originally launched with only Halo Reach. But now, with the addition of Combat Evolve, we will slowly start to see the other games trickle out. Black Mesa has officially been released. This highly anticipated remake of Half-Life 1 started development in 2004. 16 years later, it's finally here. We hope you enjoyed this video. If so, please leave a like, comment, and subscribe. It helps us out a ton. Also, be sure to check out our other content on acornhead.net. We post video game podcasts, articles, reviews, and more. Have a great day.
Now under military command.
Soldiers have arrived. They're coming to rescue us.
We should probably wait a while. Let things die down a bit.
The alien species can't possibly all be hostile, can they?
Don't bet on it. Do you have any idea that we're working on this kind of stuff? You don't still think this is a drill, right?
get to the Lambda Lab before it's too late.
It's time to choose.